Hi, energy savings in industry are really important. Here you see a picture of an industrial site where you have a lot of pipes and bands. Today, in the exercise of today, I show you how you can calculate the pressure loss over such complex networks. And it's really important to do that carefully, because in this sign, this is really important to have the proper values of the energy loss in advance. Okay, we have learned in the MOOC how you can calculate the pressure loss over a straight pipe. We did the following: draw a straight pipe with a diameter D, and the flow was going through it, and the pressure drop between P2 and P1 could be calculated by using the Fanning formula. And the Fanning formula, delta P multiplied 4 times the friction factor multiplied by the length divided by the diameter multiplied by the density and the average velocity squared. This was the formula we used to calculate the pressure loss over a straight pipe. There was one thing in this, that we had to know what the friction factor was. Well, the friction factor is, in the laminar case, we took 16 over Reynolds. And in the turbulent case, we took Blasius formula. That's one of the formula, which reads as follows. Sorry, a quarter. So we have two formulas. And now we have to know, when is a fluid in a pipe laminar, or when is a fluid turbulent? Well, we knew that the transition from laminar to turbulent is around Reynolds is 2000. So for Reynolds smaller than 2000, the fluid is laminar. So in this case, we can calculate the pressure loss over one straight pipe. How are we doing this over a band, for example? Well, assume we have a band. How do we calculate the pressure loss over the band? Well, the fluid is entering the band and is leaving the band. And in fact, we have seen that we can calculate the pressure loss over a band by a similar formula, in which we saw that the pressure loss delta P was equal to a loss coefficient, KL, multiplied by the kinetic energy per unit of volume. But here was the question, how can we have the value of the loss coefficient, KL? This loss coefficient, KL, can be found in handbooks. We have just done measurements and calculated KL afterwards, because the geometry of a bend is relatively simple, but could be a fitting or a valve that is really complex. So for a 90 degree bend, KL, well, is roughly 2. So you see, for one bend and for one straight pipe, we can calculate the pressure loss. Well, the total pressure loss of a pipe and a bend is the sum of those. So if we have a complex system where we have a number of straight pipes, then we have to take the sum of all these pipes, which can be calculated with the Fanning factor, friction factor, and his formula, plus the sum of all the bends, fittings, valves we have in the system. So, in fact, the total pressure loss we can calculate now if we have a sum of two of these two components. So let's take an example to show you this. Assume we have a system of a straight pipe, which we call 1, followed by a band, 2, followed by a straight pipe, 3, by a band, 4, a straight pipe, 5, a valve, 6, and a straight pipe, 7. we have to calculate first the straight pipes. That means 1, 3, 5 and 7. We can calculate this with the Fanning formula. And we can calculate the bends 2 and 4 by a similar formula as shown here. And we can calculate the friction loss over 4, 6 by taking the similar formula, delta P 4 is KL multiplied by 1/2 rho velocity squared. But in this case, KL will be having a completely different value than from the bend, and KL could have a value of, let's say, for example, 6. Well, in this way, you can calculate for complex systems, you get a real good estimate what the pressure loss is over straight pipes and valves and fittings. So in this way, you have to do this. Well, let's look if we have put all the formulas on one screen. You see that we started with a straight pipe, we started with a bend. Then we say, okay, sum up of all these equations give the total pressure loss. And this example shows you how to deal with it. Well, try it now yourself and try to calculate pressure loss over, well, simple system, let's say with one bend or two bends, just for practicing this type of calculations. Thanks.